Hello and welcome to the presentation about periodontal disease and other common oral health conditions. I will be narrating this session and my name is Dr. Elizabeth Schick. I'm a pediatric dentist at the University of Colorado in the United States. The objectives for this presentation are listed for you here. Please take a few moments to look over those. The contents of this presentation include an overview of periodontal disease and other common oral health conditions, learning how to identify at-risk patients, and empowering patients to manage these conditions. For the first question, we'll ask, what is periodontal disease and what other common oral health conditions can pharmacists encounter? The World Health Organization, or WHO, considers periodontal disease to be a significant global health burden. Periodontal diseases are a group of inflammatory conditions of the gingiva or gums, alveolar bone, the bone that supports the teeth, the cementum, which is the outer layer on the root surfaces of the tooth, and the periodontal ligament, the collagen fibers that connect the teeth to the alveolar bone. These are collectively called the periodontal apparatus. Periodontal diseases result from a complex interplay between the development of a dysbiotic dental plaque biofilm and the host's inflammatory response. As the immune system responds, chronic inflammation of the gums and periodontal tissues develop. This leads to clinical signs of the disease, which is inflamed, red, swollen gums that bleed more easily. It then progresses to more tissue damage, such as breakdown of the attachment between the gums and the teeth. Broadly, plaque-induced periodontal diseases are classified into gingivitis and periodontitis. Gingivitis is the bacterially induced chronic inflammation of the gingiva or gums. It's completely reversible with improved oral hygiene that will resolve inflammation. That can be as simple as improving oral hygiene, brushing, and flossing at home. The clinical features of gingivitis are shown here. If left untreated, gingivitis progresses to periodontitis. Periodontitis is a chronic, irreversible condition that leads to destruction of the supporting periodontal tissues, such as the periodontal ligament and the supporting bone. Other oral conditions are listed here for you, and I will quickly review some of those. Dental caries. The earliest visual sign of dental caries is a demineralization of the outer layer of the tooth, which is the enamel. This may appear as a white spot lesion on the enamel. If the demineralization continues, the surface of the enamel will break down and begin to cavitate, which is why we refer to it as a cavity. As dental caries progress, it can be very painful and may cause an infection of the tooth, leading to what we call an abscess. Gum diseases, I won't go into that, that's the focus of this presentation. Tooth loss can occur throughout life and is most associated with dental caries, periodontal disease, or trauma. Tooth loss has recently been linked to cognitive decline, particularly in older patients. Dry mouth is another one which can cause difficulty in speaking and swallowing. Dry mouth, also called xerostomia, may cause decline in taste and make wearing dentures very difficult. It's commonly associated with medications that older patients take. Also, children can be taking medications that cause dry mouth, but you see it more in adults. Dry mouth also increases risk of developing dental caries or cavities. Pericoronitis is defined as inflammation of the gum tissues around an erupting tooth. That can be a primary baby tooth or a secondary permanent tooth. Orofacial pain and swelling, development of pain in the orofacial region, can be associated with hard and soft tissues of the oral cavity. Oral ulcers, these can be caused by soft tissue damage due to physical, thermal, or chemical trauma. Oral thrush, also called candidiasis, is a fungal infection that develops in the mouth. It can result in a creamy white lesion on the tongue or inner cheeks. Most often affecting infants, it can also be seen in adults. Toothaches is a broad term used for any pain coming from a tooth. Every tooth has its own nerve innervation, so a continuing growth of a cavity most likely eventually leads to a toothache if untreated. Pediatric dental issues, there's a whole nother set of those. One example is teething, and that is just when primary or secondary teeth begin to erupt into the mouth and push through the gums. How can pharmacists identify red flag symptoms as well as identify at-risk patients for these conditions to promote prevention? Performing a basic oral examination to assess the mouth, teeth, gums, surrounding tissues can be very helpful. When patients present to the pharmacy, this can be done, whether they have symptoms or not. A basic oral health examination is an assessment of mouth, teeth, gums, surrounding tissues, and can help identify early signs of decay, caries, dental caries, gingivitis, gum diseases, periodontal diseases, or any other oral conditions or oral lesions. Pharmacists need to be sure they know how to establish red flags that would require immediate referral to emergency services. Some red flags would include swellings and ulcers, especially if a patient is struggling to swallow or breathe. If you see swelling that extends down into the neck area, a large facial swellings like that can be very dangerous. It is also important to note if a swelling originating from the oral cavity seems to be extending close to the orbital area towards the eye, that also necessitates a referral. Non-healing ulcers that are painless and present for 3 weeks also need to be referred for investigation of suspected oral cancer. Bleeding is the first stage of periodontal or gum disease, which eventually can lead to breakdown of periodontal structures and mobility of the teeth. Any lumps or unusual lip or tongue discolorations or spots should be referred. Large cavitations, caries, decay spots or holes, any missing, broken, or misaligned teeth. Patients at risk include individuals with systemic conditions such as diabetes, chronic kidney disease, inflammatory bowel conditions, hormonal imbalances, or hereditary syndromes. Unhealthy lifestyle behaviors such as smoking, poor diet, and individuals who are diagnosed with microbial dysbiosis are also at risk. Advice on prevention can be tailored according to patient knowledge of risk factors for dental diseases and can be targeted at high-risk groups. What recommendations and self-care tips can pharmacists employ to manage these conditions? Pharmacists should encourage and support patients to quit smoking and limit alcohol consumption as they increase the risk of gum disease, tooth decay, oral infections, and oral cancers. They should also encourage patients with periodontal diseases to visit and follow up with a dental care professional. Providing documented history during referral will help the dentist provide appropriate care for the patient and ensure multidisciplinary management and communication between medical and dental teams. If your patient experiences xerostomia, that's dry mouth, they should be on the following. They have some of the following recommendations, at least, that you can make to patients. They can stimulate salivary flow by chewing sugar-free gum. They can enhance chewing and swallowing by drinking water with meals and staying well hydrated throughout the day. For added moisture, they can explore options like alcohol-free mouth rinses or moisturizing mouth sprays or gels or artificial saliva products. Patients should avoid carbonated drinks, caffeine, tobacco, and alcohol, and use lip balm to keep the lips moisturized. Collaboration with other healthcare professionals to provide advice or substitute medications that can affect patients' oral health is also helpful. Now we'll talk about some self-care tips. There are some related to lifestyle modifications. You can encourage smoking cessation, dietary modifications, and lifestyle changes. Can encourage a reduction in sugary and acidic food consumption or drinks to help prevent tooth decay. For example, eat sweet foods or beverages or treats as part of a meal rather than between meals. Tips for dental care include educating and motivating patients on oral hygiene measures. Brushing should happen at least twice a day for 2 minutes, including right before bed, last thing before you go to bed. Remember to check the label of the toothpaste to ensure it has the correct amount of fluoride. This should be 1,350 to 1,500 parts per million for an adult. Dental floss and or interdental cleaners to prevent gum disease can be used, should be used at least once daily. Also, you can use tongue scrapers or cleaners to prevent halitosis, which is bad breath. Patients can come to the pharmacy for occasional basic oral health exams. Patients should visit their dental professional ideally twice a year, even without an apparent oral or dental issue. To summarize, maintaining oral health is a necessary life skill with extensive implications for general well-being. Regular brushing, flossing, and dental checkups help prevent tooth decay, gum disease, and other oral health disorders that can influence quality of life. Furthermore, a healthy mouth has been related to improved communication and self-confidence, emphasizing the long-term importance of addressing dental health in everyday routines. Community pharmacists are an important part of an interdisciplinary team and play a key role in early detection of oral health conditions. Timely intervention and prevention of oral health problems by pharmacists can improve oral health outcomes and reduce oral health inequalities where dental services may be costly or inaccessible. Thank you for watching this presentation. We hope you learned a little bit more about periodontal diseases and their management.